Lots of dirt is moved around on construction sites. Drone surveying helps to keep track of these projects from start to finish. In this video, we will deep dive in the cut and fill analysis for the Dawsonville project. I will also show you the tips and tricks on how to remove machines from your drone data and how to convert your 2D plan to a design surface. Stay with me right after this. Step 1. Remove machines from your drone data. There are a lot of machines on the site. I really don't want to include them in my cut and fill analysis. I enable the Remove Object tool, and I click on these dump trucks. I continue to click on all the machines that I want to remove. This tanker truck, this bulldozer, these excavators, and these trucks. I also remove these manholes and other materials that I find on site. A challenge is to find all machines. The slope steepness threshold will help me detect them. I enable the lens. The steeper areas appear red and are easier to find. I zoom in and continue to click. Here, the Remove Object tool doesn't work. I switch to the more robust Replace Terrain tool. I click around the object and it will be removed as well. I continue to search and click around until my entire site is clean. Then I can bring in my next drone survey. Step 2. The work accomplished since last week. I have two drone surveys now. One was acquired on July 8th, the other on July 15th. I move to a top-down view and load the project outline by dragging the DXF file in the project view. I select the outline and go to the Tools tab and click Volume Difference. Voila, my first cut and fill map is ready. I read the cut and fill values here on the left. I highlight the major cut and fill areas by setting a minimum cut and fill value. And I enhance the color appearance by decreasing the stretch value a little. This looks already very good. Now I will break down my cut and fill map in smaller areas. I enable the Extract Cut and Fill Area tool and click on any of the areas that I see. The first calculation takes some time, but then I can extract the other areas quickly. I continue to extract areas simply by clicking. The areas are available through separate items in the project view. I get the quantities for every area separately. I enable the volume annotations and get a better understanding of the dirt that was moved around. When I have broken down the entire area, I export all these cut and fill values to a text file. This allows me to create a more detailed report. Step 3. The work that needs to be done. Let me create a terrain state for the design first. I drag and drop the design file here. Shoot, it's a 2D file. I will need to convert it to a design surface first. I only keep the layers with the contours and the plots, and I add the elevations for each of them. I select the contour. In the Tools tab, I click Edit Z. Control A to select all the vertices. I add the elevation value here. Enter. I repeat this process for all the contours. 1, 3, 6, 2. Enter. And I also do it for the building plots. 1, 3, 6.7 for this plot. I derive all this information from the original CAD drawing. When all the geometries are available in 3D, I create the surface and modify the surface to a terrain. Then I change back to July 15th and create a new cut and fill map for the project outline, this time between July 15th and the design. I can read here the dirt that the contractor still has to move. I also enable the cut and fill annotations. This gives me an understanding of how much dirt needs to be cut or filled across the site. In the north part, the work is nearly done. While in the south, the terrain will have to be cut significantly. At some locations, even over 12 feet. Step 4, the Dawsonville project from start to finish. A cool thing is that I can pin this cut and fill map. It appears now on July 7th as well. I create another terrain state for July 25th. I add the ortho photo and the DSM. The cut and fill map appears here as well. To monitor the entire project lifetime, I added a few more drone surveys. I can show a very nice time lapse from start to finish. It looks nicest when I enable the 2D view mode. July 8th, July 15th, July 26th, August 2nd, August 8th, August 15th. And I end with my as-built state on August 26th. What techniques are you going to use for your construction site? Are you going to use drone surveys for weekly progress reports? Or monitor progress towards your design topography? Let me know and drop a few lines in the section below.